So we're finally in Waterville. We're here at the Home Depot. My scanner broke again, and this time two wires need to be soldered, and you'll never guess what I don't have. So we're going in here to see if they have a soldering iron. Then we're gonna go over to our hotel and then probably go down to the yard and see if WAPO is gonna be departing, provided the scanner gets fixed. So I got the scanner fixed, and we are going down to the Waterville yard right now to see if WAPO is getting ready to leave. Fortunately, the scanner is working pretty good. The weather won't come in, which is what I usually use to measure that, so as long as the railroad's coming in, we're good. Really hard to see, but there's a train right there. Looks like they may be making another yard move. I'm not exactly sure. They stopped right here, just in front of the crossing. Good power lash up tonight. Lash up was incredible. Even had an original Guilford in there. Day two of the 3-day trip. We're here at the Waterville yard. Look at this interesting power set. We have MEC 7595 with the pink long nose, whatever the part back here. We have MEC 7585, and we have a Guilford GP40. Let's drive and see what these are. This about sums up Guilford in three engines, or Pan Am, I should say. There's the pink on the rear, and there's MEC 510. Lovely locomotive. And there's the pink. And there's some more power over there. And down there is the intermodal yard. Nothing's happening on the radio, so I don't know. POWA this morning. Here we are at the north slash east end of the yard. Not much going on up here. Unfortunately, this is private property, so I'm not going to go any farther than this. Nice old Guilford boxcar cut in two to make some sanding, whatever you may. Down there, looks like there's some cars. I don't know if those are on storage or what, but Pan Am boxcars everywhere. I'm wondering if there's any D&H. I'm not sure.
10 feet, 5 feet. That's good.
See the intermodal yard. All those blue containers are filled with Poland Springs water. They truck it down from the bottling facility, put it on the train here. It goes on WAPO and then it goes on POAY to Ayer, Massachusetts, where it is put in warehouses and shipped by truck all around the Northeast. I don't know. I'm kind of regionally isolated. I don't know if they sell Poland Springs water in the rest of the country, but it's common around here, so. Thank you.
say ditch the Guilford locomotive, just like I would do. It'd probably break down or something. Like they're rearranging the power so it works out so that, you know, the rear unit's facing reverse and all that. I'm not exactly sure. Requested to put the 509 in leading. Probably can't lead for whatever reason. Locomotives will be facing the right way so that if they need to go north versus south, they'll always have a locomotive facing the right way. Gotta say, if anywhere on the Pan Am is still like the Guilford, it's Waterville, Maine. Looks like that'll probably be the last move they do. It is 9:36. I think the train from Skowhegan, if you're local, don't like kill me for mispronouncing all the names in your state. It's almost as bad as Quebec, no offense, but we're gonna head up to try to catch that southbound train from the mill pretty soon and hopefully chase the return trip north.
We're back here at the Waterville yard. I believe this is the job from Skowhegan. We kind of got delayed getting here, so I think we missed them coming in, but not sure what's going on. We'll find out. So it looks like the train is switching the paper plate factory before coming north. Oh, I'm hungry. This highway overpass used to be two tracks, as you can see. They obviously don't use the one on the right anymore. Pan Am tore out a lot of double track and sidings, but south of Portland, there's still plenty of sidings and the track speed is incredible thanks to the Downeaster. Those things are really pulling. I wouldn't be surprised if they hit notch 8 sometime on this trip. Funny, I thought we had to race up here. I'm back at the junction. It's right over there. Turns out they're going like 5 miles per hour, so they're still way down there, but better to be safe than sorry.
I think one more chase is in store. Let's hope we make this one. They're picking up a little bit of speed.